Welcome back. This week, we're going to explore the vast galaxy of oranges. Okay, let's start off with the navel orange, maybe one of the most common except for the Valencia. The navel orange, named for its trademark belly button there. Okay, there's 50 different varieties of these navel oranges. Really good all around. Juicers, they make a gorgeous, easy peel, nice large segments. Just a great all around orange. So you have the navels there. These are pink navels, otherwise called the caracaras. These have a gorgeous grapefruit colored flesh. Okay, these are considered a boutique in the farmers market community. There's a lack of them grown commercially. You are starting to see more and more of them. But these are just a really good all-around orange as well. Probably my favorite. Some of the attributes, nice smooth skin, aromatic when you rub it. You can smell on that. Okay, you also have a really high juice ratio to this. The coloration looks really nice as well. Just an all-around one of my favorites. Named for a Hacienda Caracara, where it was grown, first discovered rather, in Venezuela. That's how it got its name. We also have next is the Temple oranges. Okay, this is known as a Florida orange, but it does grow in San Diego County and some places in California. Really gorgeous, dark, deep orange flesh. Let's cut that open and we'll take a look at it. These are perfect for Orange Julius's because it just has a really orange forward flavor, like a classic orange juice, you know, breakfast table orange. Started off, like I say, in Florida. Nice amount of juice in those. Highly recommended if you can find them. It's kind of a rare find as far as that goes. There's also blood oranges. Blood oranges, as you see here, this beautiful coloration there. Okay, there's a lot of different varieties. There's the elongated Tarraco, there's the egg-shaped Sanguinelli. This one's the most round-shaped one. Probably the most found conventionally would be this one, the Moro. Really dark flesh, really good juice, showstopper as far as the intensity of the color as well as the taste. You'll notice some of the blushing on a blood orange. That's caused by temperature. Colder weather causes a blush. San Diego and California, you're not going to get a lot of cold weather, so you don't see a lot of, you know, some of these fruits. This is a blood orange. You don't see really any kind of blushing. Some say as well is that the deeper the blush, the deeper the color on the inside is going to be. That's not always necessarily true. As you can see here, there's this one I cut open. It's gorgeous, dark flesh. Just a light blushing as far as that goes, so not overly true, but delicious nonetheless. Vanilla blood oranges is next. Okay, this is an Italian variety. Again, you'll see a little pebbled skin, light blush on there. Okay, when you cut this one open, a little lighter pink, really nice and juicy, thin skin. Okay, this is a native to Italy. Has a pinkish hue and absolutely zero acid. This thing is just sweet as a packet of sugar, okay? Slightly bitter, maybe has a light vanilla flavor to it as well. So highly recommended if you can find them, not grown commercially. So that's this week, what's hot in the cooler for oranges.